this one is rock solid by comparison to the one that I have at the house. I have a half a dozen of these KWM2s because, you know, once you learn a radio, you may as well do a bunch of them. So every chance I get, you know, every chance I get one I can buy, right, I'll grab it and, you know, and then put it through the old overhaul process. And I haven't gotten to the point of where I can frequency compensate. I mean, you know, when you first turn it on, obviously it's going to move. But I've noticed with the one at the house, which is more extreme, that the if I do a long transmission, it tends to pull the frequency one way, and if I'm receiving for a long time, the frequency will kind of drift the other way. So there probably is some capacitors and that can be inserted or substituted that have a different temperature coefficient. Anyway, like you say, it's an old radio, and I'm not going to get too fussy about the things like the carrier or a little bit of drift. By the way, I was looking at the 7300 just for fun, and that thing is playing to mixed reviews. I was surprised. I thought that thing had no blemishes at all, but people were complaining about this and that. So ICOM 7300, even though it's a game changer and short money, it does leave some things to be desired. K1QAR.